In this video, we're going to explore editing the slide master for one of the templates that I use when creating presentations. Welcome to the Accessibility Guy channel. My name is Sean Jorison, and let's jump right in. All right, let's take a look at the slide master. I'm going to go to View and then select Slide Master. And I want to make some edits to my master theme here. And the best way that I can do this in this example, I'm going to swap out my tag logo here. I want to use a different logo that I have. And so I'm going to go find my logo that I want to use and bring it in. And it's obviously ginormous. And then I'm going to right click it and select View Alt Text. And I want to add my alternate text. I'm going to say the Accessibility Guy logo. And now it's on all of my other pages here. I also want to adjust my footer on the bottom. So I'm going to select the footer and then select Shape Format. And then this is where I can actually change my shape fill. And let's use the eyedropper tool, and I want to take one of my brand colors over here and make it like a light blue. And in addition to that, I want to change the text color of the footer to a black. And we're gonna make it bold, and we can make it a little bit brighter here. Now this changes it for all of the slides, except for what appears to be my my title slide. The title slide is always a little more unique. I'm actually gonna go ahead and delete the footer off the title slide. And I want to add another image to my title slide. I have this cool championship belt. I think it's cool. And I want to put it on the slide. And I'm just going to put it at the bottom here. I'll make sure it's centered. And then let's see if we can change the transparency. I don't want it so bold. And then let's also right click and select Format Background. And right now we're on a solid fill. Let's change it to a gradient fill. Bring a little depth to the presentation. And let's see, we can choose our preset gradients. I kind of like the blue. We can also change the colors. I'm going to change the top color to that lighter blue, and then we can select the other colors in here, and we can adjust how bright they are. That blue is just a bit too intense. Let's make it a bit lighter. Select OK. And then we can also choose like the different type of gradient that it's going to apply. Ooh, I kind of like this path one, or shade from the title. It's kind of interesting, but let's undo it. I feel like I kind of like this one the most. Again, I want to make sure my tag belt is centered. And yeah, this is good enough for me. All right, let's go back up to the top here. And I've got Calibre Light headings, but I sort of want to change the font. All right, I really like the Scream Real font, but it's a little too intense. Maybe we can try Aptos instead. But you know, my heart is just with Calibre. I feel like it's the cleanest font. So we're gonna leave it on Calibre. And I want to make sure that my other fonts, the bullet points, all look good in here. And let's just quickly review the other contents. Mostly this, when I have my comparison slide here, I really like having the bullets in here appear correctly. This actually looks pretty good. Yeah, I feel good about this slide deck. I wonder if we could add something else in here. And let's insert a table. I think that I need to put an actual table in here. Let's do insert, and we're just gonna do like this table. This is gonna allow me to set up the table visually so that it's accessible every time. So I'm gonna put some sample data points just inside of the table, like this. That way I can kind of see what I'm working with here. I'm gonna select the table, select table design. We wanna have header rows selected, possibly banded rows, and possibly first column. So we could play with setting up both. My tables tend not to be first column. I just like simple tables with a header row. And so I want to adjust it. So let's make this top level row the color of the rest of my, like the bottom footer. And that's gonna mean that the white font is not quite accessible. So we need to make the font black. And you know, I don't love the way that looks. So let's try it again. We're gonna do the shading even lighter. There we go. And then let's take, we can have the banded rows, but I would love if we could change the color up. All right, we're gonna try to select the row and then we're gonna change the shading to possibly this light gray. That should give us a little bit of information on how to, let's see. That should allow us to change some of these banded rows. Let's go ahead and insert a row below. Yeah, it looks like we're gonna have to do it manually. Although I do see the solid fill over here. So I wonder, yeah, it doesn't quite let me change. We would have to set it up manually. So I'm just gonna turn it off. I'm just gonna turn off banded rows. And then we're gonna change all of these to white. And that accidentally got rid of the lines. All right, I'm gonna select all of the data in my table, select the borders, and we're gonna do all borders because I'm boring and I like to use borders. All right, we've got header row set, we've got banded rows not set, and this looks pretty good. You can right click the table. I was gonna say we could go to properties, but perhaps I can't because we are in the slide master, but that's okay. I wanted to set up this table here to be in my slide master. Now I'm gonna copy it. And what we can do is insert another new page. And this time I'm going to paste in the table. We're gonna move it off to the side a little bit. I can actually delete one of the columns here. We're gonna shore up the, I'm gonna make the table a little smaller by moving some of the columns. And that's being annoying. So the width, we will just adjust, move it off to the side. And then we're going to insert a placeholder of just content like that. And now we have like content on the left and we have a data table over on the right. All right, so that is good for now. I feel good about our edit to our slide master. Let's go ahead and close the master view and we can delete that placeholder. And now when we add in our new slides, we have our title and content. This looks good. And we could even use like our custom slide where we have a data table on here. Oh wow, it won't let me edit it. So I definitely did something wrong there. Interesting. Let's go back to the slide master and maybe I did something wrong here. Let's grab the table. We're gonna control exit. Maybe we need to actually put in the placeholder. So we'll do placeholder table and then paste the table inside. Let's close master view, do a new slide. And now we've got this one. All right, it looks like we cannot add a table to the template. It does add it to the back of the content, but that's kind of frustrating that it doesn't allow us to make a table inside of our slide master. We can do the placeholder, but that's not really useful if it doesn't allow us to have a table in there. All right, well, I guess I could delete the table, but let's see if we can actually update one of the table layouts or table designs up here. We're gonna take this first one and up, nope, Control Z. We're gonna right click it. Yeah, there's not much we could do here. Well, that's unfortunate. I spent all that time formatting my table and I can't really use it. I guess the one thing that we could do though is like, I should be able to copy this table and then I can go to the slide master and close it. And let's delete these other slides. And I should be able to like just paste it in. So let's try that. All right, so that's one benefit, I guess, is you can like save it within the template, but you're gonna have to copy and paste it over. Yeah, so we have some major limitations with what we can do in the slide master, but at least when it comes to tables, but at least we got it in here. So that's a step in the right direction. I actually want to try to add a little bit more to my slide design master. So I'm going to go back in, select view, select slide master, and under my master title here, I want to see what else we can do here. Let's see if we go to text options. Don't want a text box. I kind of want to create like a shape. So I'm going to go to insert and let's do nothing crazy, but I don't know, maybe like an oval. And I want to just put it underneath my title. This is going to be throughout and I'm going to make it a little bit smaller. Just a nice little solid line, and we're gonna put it all the way like below the main title. I don't necessarily want it on this slide master. So I'm gonna grab my slide title or my master and try to pull it out. All right, let's try a different technique. We're gonna cut it off that main one there, and then we can apply it individually to the other ones. And we can copy it, and we're gonna paste it. I'm just gonna open up each one of these and paste it in. Oh, not that one. The table ones aren't gonna matter. And then we can close the master view. Again, we can delete out these blank ones. And then a new slide has this nice little title in here. And then we can have our text. Now, if we wanted to, we could get some more advanced graphics behind the content, but I like my content to be very simple. And yeah, that's about it for editing the template today.
That concludes today's video on how to edit the slide design theme master. Obviously, I was using my own brand as an example, but hopefully this video gave you some guidance on how to update that slide template. If you want to find out how I can help you get accessible, take a look at the link in the description of this video. And as always, I can be your champion for inclusion. Thank you so much for joining me today, and I'll see you next time.